Hello there. Welcome to this video, which I will use to explain the contents of the course Moodle Plugin Development by Example. My name is Benjamin Ellis, and I have been a web developer in the education and training sectors for over 22 years, and specifically a Moodle developer for over 9 years now. I'm the host for this course and the author of the book Introduction to Moodle 3.9 Plus Plugin Development, which is widely available as an ebook and as a printed edition in some parts of the world. So as I mentioned, in this video, I'm going to outline the contents of the course so you can decide whether this course is for you. Right, in lesson one, I'll welcome you to the course. We'll look at what is a learning environment. We'll do a small Moodle tour, looking at areas where plugins can be developed. We will then look at the Moodle plugin development environment to set yourself up for the rest of the course. And then we'll look at some development tools that are available. In lesson two, we will develop an authentication plugin. We will look at the Moodle development guidelines. We'll look at plugin, the required files for plugin development. We'll look at the string, Moodle lib and privacy APIs, and then we'll look at class autoloading and namespaces, and then we'll have another look at some of the development tools and a deeper look at the development guidelines. In lesson three, we'll develop a block plugin, and we will touch on the Access API with roles, permissions, and capabilities. We'll look at the form API. This will be part one of the form API covered in the course, and then we'll look at custom scripts and site backup. In lesson four, we will develop a report plugin, and we will touch on the events API and logging. We'll look at the navigation, page, and output APIs, and we'll finalize the lesson by looking at unit and acceptance testing. In lesson five, we'll develop a course format, and we will then revisit the file API and look at advanced file form elements. In lesson six, we will develop an enrollment plugin, and we will touch on grouping, groups and cohorts, users, roles and enrollments. We'll look at the enrollment and data manipulation APIs, and we'll finish the lesson by looking at course and activity completions. In lesson seven, we will develop an assignment feedback sub-plugin, and we will look at admin settings API, and we'll also look at the JavaScript framework. In lesson eight, we'll actually develop two plugins. We will develop an external service plugin connected to web services, and we will develop a data format plugin. We will also touch on the web services and external functions APIs. In lesson nine, we will again develop two plugins in this lesson. We'll develop a local plugin, and we'll develop a repository plugin, and we will use the task API. In lesson 10, we will develop a resource module plugin, which we will continue to do in lesson 11. And we will look at the data definition API. We'll look at the database manager class. We'll touch on the upgrade API, and we will revisit the form API again in this lesson. And then we will finalize the lesson by looking at third-party libraries. In lesson 11, we'll continue our resource module plugin development from lesson 10. We'll look at at caching and the caching API, and we'll also look at Moodle course backup and restores. In lesson 12, our final lesson, we'll develop a radio buttons custom course field. And then we'll do a roundup of the whole course and look at some of the plugins we did not cover during our course. And then we'll look at publishing or releasing your plugins to the Moodle plugins directory. And then we'll look at a couple of useful forums, the Moodle jobs and the Moodle developer forums. And then we shall conclude the course. And that is it for the outline. So if you think this course is for you, feel free to click the link below in the description and enroll. If you're a developer outside the developed world, such as in South and Southeast Asia, including India and Pakistan, in Africa, in Central or South America, and even in the Middle East, you can actually claim a discount. If, on the other hand, the course is not for you, but you do know of another web PHP web developer who might be interested in such a course, please feel free to share this video. Thank you so much for your time.